Okay. So this is for baby name. Malachi, do you have, guess a letter?
Can you guess a letter?
Could you just randomly put the letters you guess in here?
Should you give him a letter?
I'm not going to give him a letter, I know it.
Okay, he said M.
I don't think he has a letter. I don't think he has a letter.
He said M, you think?
Yeah.
Okay, Uriah, you
Daddy
pick
said
a
he doesn't have a letter. You have a letter. Pick a letter. Letter.
M.
M? Sorry. No M.
Is there an M?
No.
Nope. Daddy's gonna have to make sure that.
There we go.
A.
Please correct me, even though we're on video, if I did this wrong. I'm not used to writing this name yet. What?
E.
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 Can I say?
E's already.
Wait, Ryan, four?
I think.
Trout.
Can I guess it? I'm the second name.
You're not guessing the whole name with four letters.
Me.
You can't guess any names until you get all the names.
Everyone needs at least one round to guess a letter.
I.
Do we like vowels?
Yeah.
They don't cost money in this game. You guys don't know it, but if you play Wheel of Fortune, you have to buy a vowel. You have to spend money to get the vowel.
Maybe
the consonants for free.
All right, hold on. Name was that? Yeah.
T.
Name. No T.
No, that's a letter with two stars.
Can I say?
Wow! The gnomeman. Song. Man.
S.
Gnomes.
Oh!
Hold on. Listen, it is not your turn.
Yeah.
So Virginia went, you're right.
Hi, do you have a letter? Do you have a letter?
I don't think he has a letter. Okay, Uriah.
Me. F.
F?
Yeah.
No F.
Uh-oh. You guys are getting towards the snowman.
Oh. We'll never know the baby's name.
Right. Oh, I do snowflakes till we guess.
Abigail.
What do you think, Abigail? Consonants, but you haven't gotten any yet.
You.
Just kidding.
You.
You know you.
Do not guess yours.
Are you getting two eyes at once? Wow, you guys are in trouble.
No.
Mommy, you do one eye at a time.
All right, mommy's rules. Mommy's
Mommy,
name, mommy's
L.
Rules.
L.
L. One L.
See? I know what it is.
Okay.
I bet you don't. You can attempt to guess the entire thing or not.
Can you do it now?
Yeah.
I know what the second name is.
Do you
want to
let
him
guess or do you want to just do them by letter?
Okay. No, let's do it letter by letter. Changing the rules midstream.
Wait.
Naomi, your guess.
What? It's not what I thought. I just realized you're missing letter.
Oh.
Okay, Naomi gets to guess
letter. So far, Daddy's checked my writing.
Yep.
Samuel just went with an L.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I can think of a letter that changes everything.
N.
What?
That was the letter that changed everything. Virginia's turn. Nobody.
Okay. No.
H. Okay.
H. Oh, okay. I thought you were saying okay. I thought you were saying your letter was
no,
K.
No, I was saying K, and then I'm like, no, wait.
I know what both of them are. H. Gonna mark her down for
What's
her K guess.
Alright, hold on. We got little people.
What?
Elhanan.
Elhanan is the middle name.
What does it mean?
Oh, sorry.
I'll give you the
You right? Go.
Z.
Z? No, no Z's.
R.
R. No R.
J.
G.
Virginia?
Hold on.
G.
Gideon.
Gideon.
Gideon Alvinen. That's baby's name.
Yay.
Yay? You guys like that name? Gideon Alvinen? Is that okay? That wasn't on the don't name the baby that name.
Yeah, no, that wasn't on the don't.
Does everybody want to know why on earth I picked this name?
Yeah.
So we picked this name. So everybody knows that when mommy first proposed the name Abigail, I was like, I don't like it. Everybody's going to call her Abby. I'm not going to like it. And I don't like nicknames. And then it kind of grew on me. And then God gave us a couple of hints that it was a really good thing to call her the joy of her father, Abigail.
With that face on, joy of her father?
Hey, we're not showing her face. She's being silly over there. And then with Uriah, mommy came home from the grocery store and like, hey, this guy that checked me out at Jaws, you know, we ran the cash register, his name is Uriah. And I'm like, that's a really good reason to name a kid. And I didn't like that name either.
About him.
But I didn't like that name at all. And then, again, a couple of Bible verses and different scriptures and sermons and things all kind of came at me all at once from Psalm 27. And he ended up being Uriah Yeshua, which means Yahweh is my light and my salvation, from Psalm 27:1. So today we're going to read Judges chapter 6. We're not going to read the whole thing, but we are going to read a couple of key passages. So Judges 6, verse 12. And the angel of Yahweh appeared to him. This is to Gideon. The angel of Yahweh appeared to him and said to him, Yahweh is with you, O mighty man of valor. And Gideon said to him, please, my Lord, if Yahweh is with us, why then has all this happened to us? And where are all his wonderful deeds that our fathers recounted to us, saying, did not Yahweh bring us up from Egypt? But now Yahweh has forsaken us and given us into the hand of Midian. And Yahweh turned to him and said, go in this might of yours and save Israel from the hand of Midian. Do not I send you? So God sends him out and calls him a mighty man. And God, so the word Gideon, funny enough, doesn't mean anything about a mighty man or whatever it means. Remember what we talked about?
A feller
of trees, F-E-L-L-E-R, like somebody who cuts down trees. And you're like, that's a silly name. Judges 6, 28. And it talks about this thing where there is an Asherah pole, a false god made out of a tree, basically. Kind of like a totem pole. Like, you put faces on it and they would worship the different deities. Okay, so verse 25. That night Yahweh said to Gideon, take your father's bull and the second bull, 7 years old, and pull down the altar of Baal that your father has, and cut down the Asherah that is beside it, and build an altar to Yahweh your God on the top of the stronghold here with stones laid in due order. Then take the second bull and offer it as a burnt offering with the wood of the Asherah that you shall cut down. So Gideon took 10 men of his servants and did as Yahweh had told him, but because he was too afraid of his family and the men of the town to do it by day, he did it by night. But he still did it. So God says, they're worshiping false gods made out of trees downtown, and I want you to go rip that thing down. Verse 28, when the men of the town rose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was broken down, and the Asherah beside it was cut down, and the second bull was offered on the altar that had been built. And they said to one another, who has done this thing? And after they had searched and inquired, they said, Gideon, the son of Joash, has done this thing. Then the men of the town said to Joash, bring out your son that he may die, for he has broken down the altar of Baal and cut down the Asherah beside it. But Joash said to all who stood against him, will you contend for Baal, or will you save him? Whoever contends for him shall be put to death by morning. If he is a god, let him contend for himself, because his altar has been broken down. Therefore on that day Gideon was called Jerub-Baal, that is to say, let Baal contend against him, because he broke down his altar. So you've got Gideon now. His name is like a feller of trees, and then he goes and cuts down this false god that they're worshiping, the creature, the created thing, rather than the creator, and they give him this new name that's all about
you went and did what God told you to do, and you basically destroyed the false god. So I think that's a pretty good name, right? Verse 33, now all the Midianites and the Amalekites and the people of the east came together, and they crossed the Jordan and encamped in the valley of Jezreel. But the spirit of Yahweh clothed Gideon, and he sounded the trumpet, and the Abiezrites were called out to follow him. And he sent messengers throughout all Manasseh, and they too were called out to follow him. And he sent messengers to Asher, Zebulun, and Naphtali, and they went up to meet them. So the next part of the story, I'm not going to read the whole thing, is Gideon laying out the fleece, Gideon's all the thousands of men, and then God keeps whittling them down. And so you have the story of Gideon, who later on you find out has a very large family. So Gideon has a very large family, and Gideon is, his name means a feller, and God uses him to fell this idol, to knock down the idol. So I thought that was a really good name. Mm-hmm. And then Elhanan means God is gracious, or the grace of God. Primarily, God is gracious.
So you fell trees and God is gracious?
Right. So here's the thing. We go out and we do evangelism all the time. We share the gospel with people, right? And we're knocking down the idols, and we're saying, the things you're worshiping, the lust of the flesh, the things of the world, the things that are not God, the false ideas about who God is, all of those things, we're knocking down those idols to show you the true and living God. Okay? And this God is gracious. He doesn't need you to bring him a bunch of sacrifices like they did for Baal and the Asherahs, right? They would bring their sacrifices to try to appease this God that is no God at all. Like he said, let him contend for himself if he's a God. Let him stand up for himself. But he can't stand up for himself because he's just made out of stuff. He's not a thing. He's a made-up thing. So God being gracious in this, I think, is probably one of the primary problems we have in our day. We always say the names mean something as to what's going on today. And the people we're ministering to today all have a twisted view of God. They have an idea like, oh, I know who God is, but they're not worshiping the one true God that we see in the Bible. Mm-hmm. So I think the big key to that comes in a lot of what we've talked about Galatians. Mm-hmm. And even if I or an angel from heaven were to bring you another gospel that's based on your works, that's based on something you do, that's based on anything but the grace of God to give us, in our when we're dead in our trespasses and sins, to give us this gracious gift of Jesus that would come and live and die and rise from the dead, perfect and one-time sacrifice, a sufficient sacrifice. So God's grace is that Jesus died, and he didn't say, so you need to believe in Jesus, plus do this, plus pay this, plus bring your offerings, plus live in perpetual fear, because perfect love casts out fear. If you know God and love God, you don't have to be afraid of him. He's a father that chastises his children that he loves, but he's never going to punish us. We don't have to live in fear of the God that is wrath, that is omnipotent, because he's our father. He's adopted us into his family. So anyhow, all of that kind of ties together with the grace of God is the primary function of the gospel to talk about grace, and that's the one thing that is under assault the most today, is that God is gracious. He gives us an undeserved favor or unmerited favor. We don't do anything to earn it. Like it says in Romans 4, there's nothing about us that we add to our salvation. You know, God saved Abraham because he believed God, and his belief was credited to him as righteousness, not his belief plus his works. He was justified before God before the obedience came. But the obedience did come, because when God transforms your heart by his grace, as a gift of his grace, he's going to give you a new heart. Take out the heart of stone, give it a heart of flesh, and then you want to love him, you want to follow him, you want to serve him, and his commandments, his burden is light. It's not burdensome to follow him because we love him, because he's given us a new heart. So that's your brother's, little brother's name, Gideon Elhanan Cowperthwaite.
Three syllables. And I don't think it came out clearly, but Gideon had been suggested earlier.
Gideon had been suggested earlier.
Like Gideon.
And I didn't like it.
And then suddenly you
couldn't get
figured out this name, and you couldn't think of anything else.
So that's three times in a row that
not in a row.
Sorry. That's right, Malachi. I was all approved.
Daddy and I chose
We chose that way beforehand.
Yeah, Emily was part of that.
3 weeks after Uriah was born.
So anyway, yeah, so I didn't really care for Abigail, and then God said, hey, this is the joy of a father upon whom God has shown mercy, Abigail Rahama. And then I didn't really care for Uriah, and then God says, I'm your light, and I'm your salvation. Uriah Yeshua it is. And now, I wasn't really high on Gideon. I had a couple other names in my head, and as I tried to think through some of the other names we were talking about, I could not, for the life of me, think of anything else but Gideon Elhanan. And I was like, all right, fine. So I talked to Mommy, and she was okay with it, and so that's his name. So you can start calling him, instead of Baby, you can start calling him Gideon. You can call him Gideon Elhanan if you want to.